This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about the reciprocal and quotient identities. So let's start with the reciprocal identities. When you look at a table of the trigonometric functions, you probably notice that there seem to be pairs of functions. We've got the sine of theta is y over r, and the cosecant is r over y. In other words, what these two functions equal are reciprocals of each other. The fractions are the same things, just flipped upside down. We have the same kind of pairs for cosine and secant, x over r and r over x, and tangent and cotangent. We can take the fact that we have these reciprocal pairs, and we can create some identities, what we're going to call the reciprocal identities. So let's take a look at them. We know that the sine of theta equals y over r, and the cosecant of theta is r over y. Remember, in terms of a triangle, y would be the side, the leg, opposite theta, and r would be the hypotenuse. Now let's take this fact, and we can create an identity that says the sine of theta equals 1 over the cosecant of theta. And let's prove that that's true. The cosecant of theta is r over y, so this is going to be the same as 1 over r over y. When I divide a number by a fraction, I can turn it into a multiplication problem by flipping the fraction, taking the reciprocal of the fraction. So I've now got 1 times y over r, and that just equals y over r. So I've got sine of theta equals y over r, which is a fact that I already know. So this identity is a true identity. Now we can do that same approach with the other five functions, and we're going to get all six reciprocal identities. The sine of theta equals 1 over the cosecant of theta, and then kind of like a pair to that, the cosecant of theta equals 1 over the sine of theta. The cosine of theta equals 1 over the secant of theta. And then we have the same thing going on for the secant of theta, the tangents, and the cotangent. Okay, now let's take these identities and solve some basic problems. So a typical problem you get when you're doing these is find the sine of theta if the cosecant of theta equals the square root of 2. So the sine of theta has an identity, which is 1 over the cosecant of theta. So I'm just going to take that cosecant that I'm given and plug it into this. I'll have 1 over the square root of 2. And then I want to get rid of the radical sign in the denominator. So I've got to multiply by the square root of 2 over the square root of 2. And my answer is going to be the square root of 2 over 2. Okay? Let's do one with the cosine. Find the cosine of theta if the secant of theta is 2 times the square root of 3 over 3. Okay, so the cosine of theta, for the cosine of theta, I could say that equals 1 over the secant of theta, and then I could plug in 1 over 2 times the square root of 3 over 3 and figure out what this whole big fraction equals. But let's remember that the cosine and the secant, the fractions that they equal, are just reciprocals of each other. So let's take the reciprocal of this fraction that we have, the secant of theta, and say that the cosine of theta equals that reciprocal, just 3 over 2 times the square root of 3. And then we'll get rid of the square root of 3 in the denominator. We're going to get 3 times the square root of 3 over 2 times 3. We'll cross out those 3s, we'll cancel them out, and we're going to get the square root of 3 over 2. Okay. I want to do one with the cosecant. So I've got to find the cosecant of theta if the sine of theta, and for this I'm just going to say sine of theta equals 0.81. Okay, so the cosecant of theta equals 1 over the sine, and the sine is 0.81. So basically what this means is all I need to do is take a calculator and find out what that fraction is. So I want 1 divided by 0.81, and that gives me approximately 1.23. Now, let's take this fact, these reciprocal identities, and do one that's slightly different. For this one, I just want to say find the cotangent of 23 degrees. Okay, now, this is related to the whole idea of reciprocal identities. I'd like to use the calculator. The problem is I don't have a cotangent button. I've got a tangent button. So let's remember the identity. The cotangent equals 1 over the tangent. And now I can use the calculator to solve this problem. I'm just going to have 1 divided by the tangent of 23 degrees. And that's going to give me approximately 2.36. So I find this concept to be one of the most useful things we can do with these reciprocal identities. When we want to work with the calculator, all we've got is sine, cosine, and tangent functions. So if I want to find a cosecant, what I can do is I can use 1 over the sine. If I want to find a cosine, or find a secant, I can use 1 over the cosine. If I want to find a cotangent, I can use 1 over the tangent. Okay, so you might want to fool around with that fact. You might find it really, really useful in solving something that looks like your calculator won't be able to deal with it. Okay, but what I want to do now is go on to the quotient identities. So the quotient identities, there are two of them. They go like this. The quotient of theta, the tan of theta, tangent of theta, equals the sine of theta over the cosine of theta. So let's prove that that's true. The sine of theta is the same as y over r, and cosine of theta is the same as x over r. If I divide this big fraction by r over r, I'll get rid of all those r's, and I'm just going to have y over x, which in fact is what the tangent of theta equals. I can do a similar approach, and I can say that the cotangent of theta equals the cosine of theta over the sine of theta. Okay, so let's take those two quotient identities and work a couple of problems. This one says, find the tangent of theta if the sine of theta equals 3 over 5 and the cosine of theta equals negative 4 over 5. So the tangent of theta, one of my quotient identities, says that that equals the sine of theta, which is 3 over 5, divided by the cosine of theta, which is negative 4 over 5. I'll multiply this big fraction by 5 over 5. That will get rid of the 5s in the numerator and the 5s in the denominator. And I'm going to be left with negative 3 over 4 for the tangent of theta. And here's the last one. Find the cotangent of theta if the sine of theta equals the square root of 3 over 2 and the cosine of theta equals negative 1/2. Okay, so I want the cotangent of theta. That's going to be the cosine of theta over the sine of theta. The cosine is negative 1/2. the sine is square root of 3 over 2. I'll multiply by 2 over 2 to simplify the numerator and the denominator. I'm going to get negative 1 over the square root of 3. I want to get rid of that radical in the denominator. So I multiply by the square root of 3 over the square root of 3, and I get negative square root of 3 over 3. Okay? So that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.